Oh my god. Oh my god, my son's temperature is very high. Oh no. My son is dying. What shall I do? Yeah. I got it. It's alternative medicine. No, 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 no. It's not safe. But it's only solution. No. No, no, I'll never harm my son. I'll never do it.
In order to solve this dilemma, philosophers came up with the idea of the demarcation of science. Throughout history, philosophers developed lots of criteria categorized into two schools, the ancient school and the modern one. For the old tradition of demarcation, it all started with the Greek, so we start by the causality and certainty developed by Aristotle. He suggested that science must deal with causality and be derived from universals and should deal with the know why, not the know how. This way failed because scientific theories continuously failed and were replaced by newer and better ones. Then came the scientific method, which was supposed to replace the smug area between science and pseudoscience by a sharp line that was supposed to differentiate science from pseudoscience. After the failure of the old school, the modern school of demarcation started distinguishing science from pseudoscience depending on the verification method. We believe that any statement would only be scientific if it was verified. Then Karl Popper came to replace verification by falsification due to the appearance of verified non-scientific statement. Through falsification, any scientific statement had to be falsifiable. However, the falsification criteria itself was falsified due to the appearance of falsifiable pseudoscience such as astrology. Falsification missed its goal. Falsification was falsified. Thomas Kuhn tried something new. He came up with a new theory that he called the puzzle solving method. In the theory, he introduced a fresh concept, a new concept about science itself. This concept started with the notion of the normal science. He meant the regularly based science we all are familiar with. Then, he claimed that a normal science can be converted into a revolutionary science due to a serious paradigm shift. Following this definition, we can reach the following conclusion. Failed predictions that may lead to theories improvement is science, and what can never lead to any change is pseudoscience. Following that, the scientific progress theory was just another trial to complete Thomas Kuhn's body of work, to complete his puzzle-solving method. The theory was proposed by both Lakatos and Feyerabend. Demise of demarcation. Then came Laud and asked three important questions regarding the demise of demarcation, and he provided the answers to them as the following. The first question goes like that. What conditions of adequacy should a proposed demarcation criterion satisfy? He replied, the scientific community puts the conditions and terms to decide what is scientific. The second question goes like that. Did the criterion under consideration offering necessary or sufficient conditions or both for scientific status? The answer lies in differentiating between the necessary and the sufficient conditions. Necessary conditions must be met, or else the statement is wrong. However, the sufficient conditions are enough conditions for the statement to be true. For example, on a specific exam, if you want to get a full mark, it is necessary for you to answer all the questions correctly. However, answering all the questions correctly is sufficient for you to get a full mark on that exam. The third and final question goes like that. What actions or judgments are implied by the claim that a certain belief or activity is scientific or unscientific? The answer lies in the distinction between science and pseudoscience depending on social and political aims. The importance of demarcation. It cannot be denied that demarcation of science as an accepted notion should have huge consequences in multiple fields. such as healthcare, expert testimony, environment, and education.